Now let's move on to the fixed income market, and we of course must touch the currency. Recently we've seen the Naira come under some pressure, but now we're seeing some stability, currency trading at about 159 Naira to the US dollar. Let's now cross to Don Larry Merrifield, where Jide Nwangwogu is standing by to give us some perspective on that market. Thank you so much, Jide, for joining us. So like I mentioned, I think the good news is that the Naira is pretty stable. It has come at some cost. I see today that the central bank has sold $500 million as opposed to the usual $300 that we have become accustomed to over the last few sessions. So it's very strong action to get the Naira under control. Your thoughts on this development?
Thanks for having me, Wale. Today at the interbank market, we saw the Naira closing at 159. As from the CBN policy of trying to maintain Naira at a particular level through the sales of more dollars during the auction, we see the CBN rates remain at 155.75 till date. And within the year, from year to date, we have seen the CBN rates remaining at between 155.73 and 155.77, which all of us will see as being stable. And we can say that the CBN has done so well in maintaining the Naira stability going forward.
Well, of course, this is happening at a time when oil prices have come down quite a bit. So a little concern there. But then again, I think a lot of investors would be happy to see the central bank step up to keep that Naira stable. But let's move on to the fixed income market. Of course, the big news from last week is beyond the Eurobond roadshow that the government is on right now, is the DMO's calendar. And I want you to run us through your thoughts on their thoughts for how to issue bonds going into the third quarter. I think a lot of people are surprised at what they're planning to do.
Okay, for now, we see the federal government trying to raise more funds externally than internally.
Yeah.
As we can see from the auction calendar for third quarter that was just released, we see the range of amount that will be issued during the quarter for 140 billion to 250 billion, as against 200 to 280 billion that was planned for the same corresponding quarter of last year, while about 210 billion was raised during the same quarter of 2012. So that goes ahead to show the federal government resolve to raise more funds from external source than internal source. Well, we still see our debt to GDP ratio at about 18% from about 54% as at the year 2004. That's good enough, but we are worried. Our concern still remains that Nigeria is a nation that depends more on oil, and looking at the oil price volatility, that Nigeria still stands at a very big risk.
All right, of course. So the trend is what we're paying a lot more attention to as opposed to the absolute figures in terms of that debt to GDP ratio. But let's move on to your thoughts on the more recent activity in the secondary market for bonds. At some point, we thought there was a rally beginning to happen, but today we did see the market fall back a little bit. Can you just talk us through your thoughts on how the yield curve is playing out now?
Okay, in the fixed income secondary market, as at last week, we saw T-bills auction that was sold. Originally, we had about 55 billion on offer, but we saw the CBN coming up with another 70 billion in addition for the 364 days to make it about 125 billion on offer, where we saw the yields closing at 12.99 for 91 day, 182 day, and 364 days, which is actually slightly lower for the 191 and 182 and higher for the 364 as against the previous auction. Then at the close of market last week, we saw the yields going about 13.5, which is upper 13 levels. Then at the open of market today, we saw the yields coming down slowly, but it still reversed at midday trade to go back to the 13 upper levels.
Yeah.
That was how the market closed today.
How do you see things playing out going forward, though?
Okay, going forward, we see the market still maintaining between the levels of 13.5 and 14, because the demand in the demand pressure in the market is not much, so we don't see it pushing the yields down below the 13 levels.